Welcome everybody to NAB Stadium here in Auchenflower as Nothing But Net Media presents to you another QBL TV Game of the Week. This day, this matchup is a rematch of the 2015 QBL Grand Final Series between the Mackay Meteors and the Brisbane Capitals. It should be a great game. I'm pretty excited to be on the call today. John Guarna here with you, and I'm joined for the men's game by Dan George. Dan, Grand Final rematch, how much does that come into account for the players?
Oh, I'm not sure it comes into it too much for these guys. I mean, last year was obviously a pretty big stage they met on, but this year is a little bit of a different story. It's looking at the standings, and I reckon if I'm playing today, I'm more worried about trying to get our season on track and get an important W on the road. And for Brisbane, they've got to come out and protect home court as well. So I think in the lead-up, maybe the rematch of a final might be on their mind, but once the ball goes up, I think they're just going to go out and play, and it's all about today.
Yeah, it should be a good matchup. You mentioned there both teams come into this game on the back of wins. Brisbane got a big win last week at Ipswich, 101-85. Aaron Anderson led the way in that one, 28 points, 10 rebounds, and 8 assists. He did tweak his leg a little bit, but in the warm-ups, he looks very healthy. And Dusty Reichardt chipped in with a double-double of 13 points and 15 rebounds. But Brisbane has struggled. They've had a couple of tough losses. They lost to Townsville, up in Townsville, and then they lost at home a few weeks ago to Southwest.
Yeah, and I'm interested to see how they come out today as well. And I think Jeff's obviously got a certain style that he plays, but I'm not sure that style changes too much week to week and season to season. And it might be a case of people knowing how to play the Capitals now and how to get them out of their stuff. So if he can make some adjustments, I think they'll bounce back with a good win against a quality team today. But if he can't, they might continue to struggle a little bit in 2016.
Yeah, and the defending champion Meteors come into this game with a record of 4-3, and a few of those wins came this week, and they've won both games so far in this three-game triple header. This is the third game in 3 days for the Meteors. On Friday night, they won 99-88 at the Sunny Coast Phoenix. TJ Diop had 24 points. Nick Wiggins with the double-double of 20 points and 11 rebounds. And then last night, the Meteors won 78-77 at the Sunshine Coast Rip. Sean Bruce had a big game, 22 points. His strong start to the weekend with 17 points and 8 rebounds. If you are the Meteors, what do you have to do to get a win over the Capitals here in Auchenflower?
Well, third game in 3 days is always tough, especially for a team that plays five or six guys. And those two scores you just read out are both close games. So I reckon their main guys have logged heavy minutes the last 48 hours. So they're an experienced group. The backcourt of Cedar and Sean Bruce obviously have a lot of experience, a lot of basketball smart. So I'm probably going to control the tempo. The last thing they want playing their third game in 3 days is get into a running match with the Capitals that have no structure at all and just want to play up tempo. So they can slow the ball down, control the boards, play their style and their pace. I think Mackay's going to look to do that and come out with a third win.
Yeah, I'm very much looking forward to seeing Sean Bruce and Nick Wiggins for Mackay. Bruce has signed with the Brisbane Bullets, the returning Brisbane Bullets, and Nick Wiggins is the older brother of Andrew Wiggins of the Minnesota Timberwolves. Wiggins has logged some minutes in the D-League and in Summer League with the NBA. Right away, we see the Capitals come off firing from three. Carter well short with that.
That's a common theme, 2016.
So the matchup right away, you see Kurt Thompson with the defensive assignment of Sean Bruce. Now Wiggins had it. He's guarded closely by Jeffries. Jeffries gets a hand on the ball. Not a great start to the game for the Mackay Meteors here as Brisbane packs it in. Rasmussen for a corner three. That's well long. And Jeffries comes up with it.
Yeah, pretty ugly possession to start for Mackay. They're going to want to play for a lot more structure than that.
Reichardt baseline jump shot. No good. Cedar comes down with it. Kicks it ahead for Bruce. Now Bruce going to be guarded this time by Aaron Anderson. Splits the defense, can't get one off. He gets it out to Rasmussen. Now Wiggins for three, that's up and that's strong. Anderson with the defensive rebound. So we see that pack defense right away from Brisbane.
Well, it's an interesting start. We've had four possessions, two for each team, and 4 3-point attempts. Make that five.
Make it five as Carter gets the Capitals and the scoring opened here with a 3-point shot. Carter on the season only shooting 28.6% from three. That will not stop him from firing away, though.
No, it won't. I'm not sure if that's good or bad, but maybe you'll mix it up and get in the post every now and then, but I'm not sure that's the Cap style either.
The Capitals love to shoot the ball. Cedar's going to fire top of the key three, and he answers with his own. So it's a three all game. Reichardt beats the defense down the court, but he loses the ball out of bounds. And that was a theme we saw in the women's game, Dan, the transition offense slash defense. Both teams struggled in transition. Now let's see if it carries over into the men's game. Wiggins guarded very closely by Ryan Jeffries. Giving him the left. He goes left. Hands it off for Jopp. Jopp's going to step back and kick it out for Wiggins. About 5 seconds to go on the shot clock. Wiggins inside for Jopp. Hook shot is good. Don't know if he meant to pass it, but it was a good look. Carter going to fire from three again. That rolls in and out, and Jopp with the rebound.
When Mackay, we spoke about their third game in 3 days. I'm not sure that going one pass, jacking a three ball from Zach Carter is a great option. They want to grind it out and make these guys play defense and make them work hard, because 3 games in 3 days is a tough ask, and letting them off the hook like that's not going to help Brisbane.
Yeah, Reichardt's going to hit the long two. His foot was on the line. I'm with you, though, Dan, but that is the Brisbane style of play. They like to run and gun. They will fire at will. You know, they'll look to pack it in inside and try and outscore you on the other end. Jopp misses.
And I think that's great, John, but when you're shooting 28% on the season, you might want to take your time and be a bit more selective with your shots. But Anderson gets into the post and gets a layup, and I reckon that's exactly what they're going to want to do all night long.
Yeah, Brisbane's happy with this pace early, as Mackay has been firing quick shots off early here. Wiggins going to fire from three. That's good. No, the pack defense doesn't work if you leave him wide open from outside, as Rasmussen gets his hand on the ball, knocks it out of bounds. You still got you can pack it in, but you still got to close out. You can't just completely leave him wide open at the arc.
Rasmussen, I haven't seen him play in a while. He has got an impressive tattoo game going on. And some good defense as well.
But Carter goes right through the Rasmussen D. We haven't seen him inside early. This time he finishes through the contact and the foul. So he gives the Capitals a lead, and he has an opportunity to complete a three-point play. I like what Carter did there, though. You know, use that shooting or the shooting ability to get the defense to close out too tight and go around him. I haven't seen enough of that from him so far this season. Carter's free throw, no good. TJ Jopp with the rebound. It's a tough assignment for Kurt Thompson. He seems to get those point guard / scoring guard defensive roles as Jopp flips one up and in. Again, Jopp very impressive here early.
That's a nice move from a big man. Good touch with the left.
Yeah, Jopp has found a home in Mackay as Anderson fires for three. That's short.
You can see Mackay going to a zone D as well, and just from the comment earlier, just really encouraging the three ball and just taking a bit easy on D. They don't want to play for 24 seconds down there, and Brisbane's more than happy to get it up.
Ball knocked out of bounds there by Jeffries. 13 to go on the shot clock. Let's see what Mackay's got here out of the baseline. Bruce flips it over to Cedar. Cedar wasn't ready for it. Now Chris finds Sean Bruce, fires for three, top of the key, no good. Tip to Wiggins, who finishes it underneath. Jeffrey's going to fire for three, and he answers right away. Tell you, you got to love, if you're a player, you'd have to love playing in this system. Wiggins fires from two. You're going to give him two? Yep. Dusty for three, that's no good. Winds up with Aaron Anderson. He'll fire again from three, that's good. Just a frenetic pace, isn't it?
I was about to say that. It's going to be 120 all the way these guys are getting the shots up if they can make them. No one's worried about the shot clock at all today.
Yeah, Reichardt fouls Jopp as he got good position in the paint. Going to call it shooting. No, it's going to be on the baseline out of bounds. So checking in to the game for Mackay, you've got Tendekai Machando, number 21, in for Chris Cedar. And then Anthony Kopskis checks in for Kurt Thompson. Wiggins getting set to inbound for Bruce off the screen. Baseline jump shot is good. Sean Bruce isn't the flashiest of guys, but gee, he's effective.
Well, you think with the experience he's got, he's just smart. Had a decent couple of years in the Siebel, playing down south, and obviously been up north in the Taipan system for a while. So So I don't think you get to that point and then get signed by the Brisbane franchise without just being a really smart player. And when you're not athletic, that's what you have to be. And I think in a game like today, when they're all fatigued, third game in 3 days, that kind of IQ is what's going to get Mackay over the line.
Wiggins has it on the wing, guarded by Jeffries. He's going to pull up for three. That's short. Rasmussen can't tip it in, and Kopskis comes down with it for Brisbane. Here's where Anderson is strong in transition. Carter's going to fire a corner three. That's short. Bruce comes up with it, and Mackay's got numbers. Three on two here. Bruce crossing over, and he's fouled by Kopskis. That's a good foul there by Anthony Kopskis.
Yeah, he saved a guaranteed layup. Well, I'm not sure it's their game, but Diop's looked tough on each catch that he's gone, especially with Tom Moy coming in now. Follows Mackay. I'll just try and grind it out and just dump it inside and get some inside looks. Looking at Brisbane in foul trouble. I'm not sure they want to keep playing at this pace, taking quick shots like they're doing. I'd look to get drop going inside, and if they can do that, that's going to open up for their three-point shooters. They're forcing the shot too much at the moment, in my opinion.
We'll see what Mackay does, but Brisbane goes to the bench, inserting Drew Phillips, Tom Malloy, and Alex Barker. Wiggins finds Bruce in the corner for three. That's up and good. Going to call it a two. I thought it was three. Malloy hit his first three-pointer of the season last week. Drew Phillips misses one. Bruce comes down with it, and then he's fouled there by Barker. So it's three team fouls now for Brisbane. Only one on Mackay. It's 18-15 with just about 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. Mitch Gamblin going to check in for Nick Wiggins. See Mackay go to the bench here early. It's going to be a key aspect of the game for Coach Ken Furtick. As you've been touching on, Dan, three games in 3 days, it's not easy. Bruce pass is nearly stolen. It's knocked out of bounds, but they're going to be a foul. There's a foul on the play. That one's going to go on Anthony Kopskis. That's going to be Kopskis' second personal foul here early. Luke Harvey checks in for TJ Diop. So I like what Coach Furtick's doing. You got a little lead, let's work the bench a little bit.
Yeah, I agree. It's a matter of managing minutes today for Mackay for sure.
Pass inside for Harvey. He goes baseline, kicks it out. Bruce is wide open. Corner three is up, and that's good.
And John Harvey might not be a huge threat in the post, but just by getting it inside, just the way Brisbane play D, they're taught just to collapse straight away, and it leads to an open shot. And they've got to do more and more of that as we come down and jack up an air ball, and that plays into Mackay's hands perfectly, that kind of offense from Brisbane.
Yeah, I think what we see Mackay doing is running that half court, and they are keying, trying to get the ball inside. They want to work the shot clock. They want to try and keep the pace at a minimum here as Bruce again going to fire for three, and that's good as well. Back-to-back threes for Sean Bruce give the Mackay Meteors a nine-point lead. Again, we see that kind of the collapsing defense, and Mackay just sitting back, letting Brisbane shoot in the threes. Phillips nearly loses it, and then he travels, so that is a turnover. Jeff Tarrant not happy with what he sees out there, so he's going to take a timeout. We'll take one as well. 2:50 to go in the first quarter. It's a nine-point lead for Mackay on QBL-TV, presented to you by Nothing But Net Media.
In-depth video analysis is no longer just for the pros. Huddle is an easy and affordable tool that brings professional level insight to club and high school teams. Just film and track events live at games and upload them to huddle.com. Accelerate player development with team messaging, automatically generated shot charts and reports, and the ability to add notes and drawings to your video. Coaches can exchange game footage with their entire league, all from one place. Sign up for a free trial to see for yourself how Huddle helps teams win.
Welcome back to NAB Stadium here in Auchenflower. It's a nine-point lead for Mackay here with about 3 minutes to go in the first quarter, Dan. And Coach Tarrant not happy with the defense there. Mackay just getting a few too many easy three-pointers wide open.
They are, and I reckon that comes from Brisbane's offense a lot as well. It's pretty hard to to come down and go one pass, jack a corner three for an air ball, and then come down and play quality defense as well.
Machando is going to fire for three. That rolls in and out. Gambling, though, with the offensive rebound out to Nick Wiggins, who fires away for his own three. That's good as well. It's a three-point shot doing damage here for Mackay. Kopskis answers with his own three. So back and forth we go here. It's going to be a three-point shootout here, it
sure
looks
is.
Like. And Mackay, the thing that I think the difference in the three-point shot, though, is that Mackay's not settling. They're not just jacking. They're working the ball. They're getting it through hands as Cedar fires for three. That's no good. And where you see Brisbane, they, quite often we're not even seeing a pass. It's just dribble up and shoot.
That's right.
Phillips throws one away. Drew Phillips forcing the action here. Coach Tarrant not happy about that. Immediately going to reinsert Ryan Jeffries. So Mackay's got Bruce, Gamblin, Harvey, Cedar, and Wiggins. Brisbane answers with Jake Davis, Kopsikas, Barker, Malloy, and Jeffries. Bruce has his pass tipped by Davis. Malloy comes up with it. So good D there by Jake Davis. Now Jeffries has it crossing over, throws up the floater, it's short. Great rebound there by Sean Bruce.
Well, it looks like Brisbane the last couple of possessions has just been switching everything on D just to try and disrupt them somehow, and you almost see Wiggins almost throw it down over the young fella out there.
And that foul's gonna go on Jake Davis. That's the fifth team foul, so Wiggins will go to line for two shots. Great look on the backdoor cut though from Cedar to Wiggins.
Yeah, sure was.
Now Wiggins going to go to the free throw line. Nick Wiggins on the season is averaging a massive 22 points a game. He only shoots 67% from the free throw line. He's hit double figures in every game. His season high is 32 in the game versus Rockhampton. It's the first one.
Just a really impressive, versatile play by the look of it. First time seeing him live, John, at least for me. And obviously offensively he's talented, but not afraid to get after on the defensive end. And that's what you want from an import, to come out and set the tone for the rest of the team and all the locals. And here he's picking up the ball again in transition.
Yeah, he misses the second one, so the lead is 10, 28-18. Davis going to fire for three. That's long. Harvey and Malloy battle for it, and Bruce comes down with it. Now Cedar up ahead. Cedar, great look for Harvey. Harvey, though, just cannot contain the pass.
He took three Brisbane players out, but just couldn't catch the ball, unfortunately. But
yeah, Tom Malloy comes up with a bit of a limp. Let's hope he's all right. But how about that look from Cedar? Harvey was a great
it's
rim
awesome
running
pass.
There from the big fella.
So this is what I don't quite understand, and not to harp on it, but why would Tom Malloy run to the corner to start their offense? At 6 foot 11, surely they got to have a bit more of a focus inside, I would think.
I mean, that's the Capitals game. They clear you out. They really don't play with the post presence. Even when they have Reichardt in there, they go five out. Kopska's going left, looking to split the D. Flips one up, no good. Malloy with the follow tip, but they're going to say it's an offensive interference. He grabbed on the rim before he tipped it up and in. Kind of like the aggressive move, though, out of him.
Absolutely.
Malloy has really, to me, has grown as a player. I think defensively he's been a real presence, and offensively he's shown the touch. If they get him the ball and give him an open look, he's going to finish.
I agree. I think he's really great servicing role player, especially in this league, and not the kind of guy that's going to complain about calls not getting, not getting called for him. He's happiest to go and play his role and play good D, and like we just saw, hit the offensive glass. I mean, everyone loves playing with someone like that, and you'd like to see him rewarded with a couple of easy looks every now and then, but he's just happy to do his role and try and help his team get a win, which is obviously what it's all about.
Gambling at the line, hits them both. 12-point lead now. Got about 40 seconds. Barker hits Kopskis back out to Jeffries. He's going to fire a long one from three. That's strong, but it rolls in. Talk about the friendly bounce. That couldn't get more friendly than that. 30-21 the lead here. We got about 25 seconds now. Harvey has it top of the key. Hits Cedar in the corner. He'll fire from three. That's way off. Bruce gets it. No contact with the rim, so the shot clock doesn't reset. Gamblin's going to fire top of the key three. That's short. Malloy with the rebound. And with 9 seconds to go, Jeffries has it for Brisbane. And then Cedar going to give the foul. It's not a great foul as they're already in the penalty. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Looking at Brisbane, that's Mackay's only second team foul. So a great foul there from Chris Cedar. Barker out to Kopsikas. Now that looks inside for Jeffries. Jeffries wasn't ready for it. You got 2 seconds to go on the game clock here. Brisbane going to go with the baseline out of bounds. Jeffries inbounds for Davis. He's got to get the shot off. Throws up the floater. It's good. That one's going to count as Jake Davis beats the buzzer to send the game, well, send the team into the quarter break down 7. It's Mackay 30 over Brisbane 23. We'll take a break and come back with second quarter action here on QBL TV, presented by Nothing But Net Media.
In-depth video analysis is no longer just for the pros. Huddle is an easy and affordable tool that brings professional-level insight to club and high school teams. Just film and track events live at games and upload them to huddle.com. Accelerate player development with team messaging, automatically generated shot charts and reports, and the ability to add notes and drawings to your video. Coaches can exchange game footage with their entire league, all from one place. Huddle even allows athletes to create highlights to help them get noticed. Sign up for a free trial to see for yourself how Huddle helps teams win.
Welcome back to NAB Stadium here in Auchenflower. It's a seven-point lead for Mackay, 30-23, heading into the quarter time break. Take a quick look at some stats. Sean Bruce has 10-4. Mackay also has 6 rebounds. Nick Wiggins with 11, 2 rebounds and 3 assists. You got Chris Cedar with 3, TJ Diop with 4, Gamblin with 2, and that's all the scoring for Mackay. Doing a lot of their damage in transition, but they are shooting 52% from the field, 45% from 3.
What a great end to the quarter the Capitals had, with Ryan Jeffries getting a shooter's touch on a three, and then young Davis making a great play on the buzzer to bring it back to a seven-point game, because down 12 is not a great place to be. But Sean Bruce and his IQ just stepping up for Mackay again.
Yeah, that was a tough hit there by Bruce. He recognized the mismatch, and then he gets the steal off of Jeffries the other end. Kicks ahead for Cedar. Cedar's layup is good. I love it when you get a steal, you go right down the other end and lay it in. It's good to get that reward right away. And you see the contrast in styles here. Malloy has it in the corner. Davis puts it on the deck, instead pulls up for three. That's it. That's good. Good hit there by Jacob Davis. Cedar's going to fire for three. That's short, but he's fouled by Ryan Jeffries. It's going to be Jeffries first, and it's going to send Chris Cedar to the line for 3 shots. Take a quick look at the Brisbane Capitals stats. Ryan Jeffries has 6, Carter and Anderson with 5 each. Jake Davis has 5 as well. Brisbane shooting 45% from the field, 50% from 3. So, you know, they're both teams shooting the ball fairly well to start the game.
Well, I know Jacob Davis hasn't played a huge role on the season. He's averaging a couple of points a game, but for a young kid to come out today, he's not scared of anybody. Wiggins guarding him, and more than happy to make a great move on the first quarter buzzer and then pull up for a three just then. I think it's wonderful to see some local players getting developed through the cap system, which is great to see.
Cedar hits all three, so the lead is 37-26. Anderson back in. Now Davis going to fire a corner three. That's a bit strong. Cedar comes down with the rebound, and he busts out. Now Bruce has it. He's doubled. He thought he was going to get doubled. Rasmussen, they work the ball around the perimeter. It's a bit of a one, like a box and one here from Brisbane as Wiggins hits, misses the corner or the baseline floater, and Rykar comes up with it. What'd you call that D that Brisbane's playing? I know they pack, but
Phillips. I'm not sure. We'll have a look at it again here, but they were absolutely packed in and focused entirely on Sean Bruce.
Yeah, Phillips misses the three on the other end. Drew Phillips has really struggled so far this season. And Brisbane, he's a key contributor for Brisbane. They really need him to get going. They want to make some noise again this year. Cedar using his body to shield the ball, leaves his feet. Rasmussen, baseline jumper, is strong as well. Job fighting for it, and Barker comes down with it. Anderson powering it up the court. Davis now. Work it around to Phillips on the wing. Reichardt's going to step into a long two, which rolls in and out. Bruce with another rebound. Gee, he probably has nearly a double-double already. And a foul called there as Reichardt trying to guard Chris Cedar. Oh, they're going to give that one to Barker. I guess it must have been inside, and that's going to be Barker's third personal. So he's going to take a seat on the bench. He's going to be joined on the bench by Jacob Davis. And for the Capitals, Kurt Thompson and Zach Carter check back in. Wiggins is double teamed, tries to hit Jop. It's stolen though by Thompson. Thompson goes to the left wing, skips it across for Drew Phillips. Layup is good by Drew. Nice look there by Kurt Thompson. Bruce goes off the foot of Dusty Reichardt, so it'll stay with Mackay. Coach Ken Furtick of Mackay is going to take a timeout, so we'll take one as well. It's about 7:30 to go here in the first half, and Mackay up 9, 37-28 on your QBL-TV Game of the Week, presented to you by Nothing But Net Media.
In-depth video analysis is no longer just for the pros. Huddle is an easy and affordable tool. In-depth video analysis is no longer just for the pros. Huddle is an easy and affordable tool that brings professional-level insight to club and high school teams. Just film and track events live at games and upload them to huddle.com. Accelerate player development with team messaging, automatically generated shot charts and reports, and the ability to add notes and drawings to your video. Huddle even allows athletes to create highlights to help them get noticed. Sign up for a free trial to see for yourself how Huddle helps teams win.
Welcome back to NAB Stadium here in Auchenflower. It's a 9-point lead for Mackay, 37-28. And then the 3-point shots for both teams have kind of settled down a bit. We've seen a lot more action inside the paint from both teams.
Yeah, absolutely. It seems like both coaches got that point across at quarter time, because the first 10 minutes was frenetic in terms of the number of attempts that got up. And you're seeing a little bit more structure here now, and Brisbane really tightening up their defense a little bit as well. So let's see if Mackay can, as Drew Phillips is called for a bit of a cheap foul, but let's see if Mackay can run some structure. I would even just love to see them just to go some side on balls with Sean Bruce and the big fella Giop, just to see what they can create out of that, and just play out of that for a while, because at the moment they're struggling to score in this quarter.
Double team, Cedar loses it. Giop finds Rasmussen wide open though underneath the basket. A bit of a fortuitous bounce there for Mackay. Let's see what Brisbane can do here. It's a bit of a zone now from Mackay. Anderson has it now. He's going to step into a three. That rolls in and out. Reichardt, though, comes up with it. Fadeaway jump shot for Dusty, no good. Somehow Anderson nearly comes up with it. Goes out of bounds off of Anderson. So Mackay's going to have the ball. So different look defensively there from Mackay. Kind of confused Brisbane a bit.
Well, I think you got to mix it up. And I reckon just switching everything against this Brisbane offense will work really well too. But if you just keep them guessing, don't let them get into their normal routine, makes it difficult, because there's not a lot of secondary offense for the Capitals.
Cedar is going to fire for three. That's no good. Zach Carter with the defensive rebound. Up ahead to Phillips. Phillips puts it on the deck and kicks it out. Anderson's going to fire top of the key three. That's good. They really need to get Aaron Anderson going. He's a tremendous weapon for them. He's settling for his three-point shot a bit too much for my liking here early. Thompson got his hand on the ball, went out of bounds just in front of the Mackay bench. Mackay is going to maintain possession with 16 seconds to go on the shot clock. 39-31 the lead here for Mackay. Just about 6:20 to go. Cedar skips it to a wide open Wiggins. Pump fakes, then he's going to step back, fire from three. That's short. Jopp with the offensive rebound. Can't put it back in, and then he's fouled. See who they give that one to. That one's going to go on Drew Phillips. That's going to be his second personal. Hey, we saw early in the game, right at the start of the game, they're looking to hit Jopp around that free throw line where he's tremendously effective. We haven't seen him really go inside to that since.
And I think that's partly Brisbane's defense as well, just packing it right in. There's not a lot of space at that free throw line, although he obviously gets a good look there.
Huge jam there from Jopp off the creativity of Brett Rasmussen. Anderson's going to try and answer for three. That's no good. Thompson misses the tip. Ball trickles out, and Bruce comes up with it for Mackay. He goes right to the rim. He lays it in, and he's fouled by Dusty Reichardt. What a transition bucket there from Mackay, and the foul.
Well, Sean Bruce has just got control of this game while he's on the floor. When the matchup with him and Anderson, you'd think we'll go a long way towards deciding who comes out with the win today. But both quality players, but you can just see Sean Bruce's smarts really coming out at the moment.
Bruce's second one, free throw is up. That's good. So it's a 13-point lead here. Cedar is going to take a breather, and Machando is going to come back in for Mackay.
I mean, this sort of scoreline, the way the game's going, is just perfect for Mackay. It allows the coach to manage minutes. Third game in 3 days, which is good. And I mean, Brisbane's really going to make a push here in the last 4 or 5 minutes of the quarter just to get this game back and a little bit closer on the scoreline just to try and wear these guys out, because you would expect Mackay to be a bit gassed in the third or fourth quarter, especially given the weekend that they've had.
Yeah, I'm actually quite surprised that Brisbane isn't really picking up more full court on makes and trying to really wear out Mackay physically. I thought you maybe see a bit of trapping, a bit more full court press, at least
I
on
agree.
Makes.
Absolutely.
Try and take that to your advantage.
Well, Anderson is tiny from a basketball point of view, which means he must be quick, probably one of the quickest players in the league. So let him pick up Sean Bruce, 94 feet. Just wear them out. I think you'll see the benefit of that in the third or fourth quarter. But so far, that hasn't been the strategy. But
Rasmussen,
they may get to that.
Rasmussen hits the long two. That's good. So again, you know, Brisbane, they're not putting together 24 seconds of complete defense. They're putting together spurts as Thompson cuts to the basket. Carter hits him. 11-point lead now for Brisbane. Mackay. I'm all over the shop today, Thunder.
Well, it's Sunday afternoon, and that's very acceptable, Johnny.
Job guarded tightly by Kurt Thompson. Hits it to Bruce. Alley-oop pass to Rasmussen, who can't handle it. It's out of bounds.
I think Sean Bruce thought it was Nick Wiggins cutting baseline for a second. Slightly out of reach.
Yeah, Rasmussen was wide open, though, along the baseline there. No one near him. Gamblin checks in for Nick Wiggins, so a bit of bench action here from Mackay. Thompson has the ball now. Hits Reichardt. Reichardt guarded closely by Jopp. Give and go to Thompson. That's a great pass and a great finish.
It's almost the same exact look, two plays in a row.
Yeah, I like the aggressive play there from Kurt Thompson, and people forget the basics, don't they, Thunder? The give and go is a bread and butter move.
Absolutely.
Tough D, tight D there by Thompson. He's going to get called for the personal. That's a penalty there for Brisbane, so Bruce is going to go to line for two shots. And that's just a smart play by Bruce, recognizing that it's a really close guard and just creating
Absolutely.
The contact.
Yeah.
Bruce misses the first. Be good to see him in a Bullets uniform. Be good to see the Bullets back.
It'll be good to see a Bullets uniform full stop, but it's also good to see young Aussie players coming up, and you would imagine he'll play a pretty important role. I know they've got Adam Gibson and possibly an American in the backcourt as well, potentially, but hopefully Sean Bruce gets the chance to show everybody what he's able to do.
Yeah, I mean, he's been one of the guys that has steadily improved his play throughout the course of his career. I remember him being a development player at with the Cairns Taipans, and now he's starting as Jeffrey steals it from Bruce and throws it down. Good steal. That activity might get things going here for the Capitals as they pick up full court here.
Well, we just spoke about the pressure defense, didn't we? And first time they do it, they get a steal and a jam, which, again, we've got a pretty good crowd here on a Sunday afternoon, and there hasn't been a whole lot to cheer about. And a bit of energy and a dunk get the crowd involved. And again, they've got 3.5 minutes, 8-point game. There's an opportunity for Brisbane really to close the gap and give themselves some momentum. And maybe the thought comes into Mackay's head that a 2-1 result's not a bad weekend. But at the moment, they're looking at 3-0. So Brisbane's in foul trouble, and Mackay's is keeping this score ticking over at the foul line at the moment. But an interesting 3 minutes coming up for both squads, I think.
Yeah, Kopska's picked up his third personal foul. Brisbane already in the penalty, so Mackay will be shooting free throws from here on out. Rasmussen hits one of two. 9-point lead, 48-39. Barker on the floor, goes right at the defense. He's fouled. It's a pretty, looked like a pretty good defensive job there by Gamblin, but Barker created the contact, and he's going to go to line for two shots. On the season, Barker has hit 75% of his free throws. Big shout out to Chris Sieber once again on the camera for us. He's a bit tired working over at Cusack this morning, double dipping. He's going to head back there straight from this game. Got to thank Chris for all the work he does with us on the camera, doing a great job as always. And, of course, calling the game with myself is Dan George. You played a few games here in Auchinflower, haven't you, Thunder?
I played a few games here, definitely. I mean, Brisbane's such a great association, a lot of juniors, pretty awesome facility, but been a little bit championship starved, not since 2002. Have they won a title here, and so close last year, and hopefully for the sake of the crowd, they can get their season turned around and really challenge again this season coming up.
Yeah, that's certainly the goal. They've made it to the grand final a few times, but they haven't been able to get over the hump. The goal for the Capitals this year, it's grand final champions or bust. Kai going to go to the bench. Cedar checks back in, as does Nick Wiggins, and Rasmussen and Machando take a seat on the bench. Cedar getting set to inbound. Hits Wiggins with about five to go on the shot clock. Gamblin hits Cedar in the corner. Three is up. That's good. Very well run baseline out of bounds set there from Mackay. Jeffrey's going to take up jump shot. That's no good. Gamblin with the rebound. Hands off for Cedar. Cedar tries to get up ahead to Wiggins. Pass just a bit too far ahead of Nick Wiggins. Jacob Davis back in. Hits Malloy. Malloy's blocked by Harvey. And then nearly saved by Gamblin. What a block there, though, by Luke Harvey.
It was a great recovery and a great block. But getting a look at the bucket like that's a good result. But hopefully Tom Malloy stays in there and battles for another easy bucket down low soon. Because that's not a great feeling when you get stuffed like that.
Jacob Davis for three, that's no good. Malloy can't come up with it, but he gets it. Somehow Kopskis comes up with it. Jeffrey's going to fire for three, that's off as well. Tipped around, Jake Davis nearly saves it. He gets it to Jeffries, who lays it up and in. It wasn't pretty, but it worked. Lead back down to nine now for Mackay, with about 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Wiggins, an offensive foul called there on Luke Harvey, and then a technical foul called.
This is unbelievable.
On Nick Wiggins.
It's the sort of officiating that just ruins basketball in Queensland for me. How can you call a technical in that situation? It's just a young ref who's out of his game, out of his league, if you ask me. So disappointing. Pretty quality game, and then we get a call like that.
Things got a little bit scrappy there. I don't know exactly what happened. Didn't look like there was much contact or anything. Maybe it was something Wiggins said. Who knows? But at the end of the day, he's hit with a technical with 2:06 to go here in the first half. So Jacob Davis looks like he's going to be taking the technical foul. And Luke Harvey was called for an offensive foul as he shoved Kopskis out of the way. Davis hits him. Hits the free throw, so it's now a 8-point lead. Brisbane will have possession. They already had possession anyway, so that's not the bonus. But yeah, I thought it was a fairly soft technical as well. Kopskis way downtown is strong. He's going for it as Barker. He can't keep it, can't control it. Gamblin comes down with it. Now Cedar double team, working on Kopskis. Kicks it ahead for Wiggins, who drives baseline, tries to throw it, it hits the backboard. Winds up with Bruce. Now gambling for three, that's a bit strong. Malloy comes up with it.
One of the ugliest possessions I think we'll see on nothing but net media for a while. Almost resulting in a banked three, but here's Brisbane down eight with a minute 30 left. Chance to close the gap.
Yeah, but Brisbane obviously getting into the heads of Mackay. Mackay's looked very sloppy these last few minutes here. Kopska's putting his head down, can't hit the floater. Harvey, though, tips it, and Gamblin comes up with it. It's knocked out of bounds by Malloy. Malloy's got a bit of blood coming out of the bridge of his nose. Looks like he caught an elbow somewhere, somehow. So Coach Tarrin has to go to the bench, and he'll reinsert Zach Carter. Things are getting a bit scrappy here in the last couple of minutes. That was one thing Brisbane did last week. Ipswich was close, but Brisbane kind of made things a bit scrappy, and then they ran away with the game.
Well, that's the concern as Cedar drains a triple, much needed, just to stabilize things for Mackay. That's the concern for a fatigued Mackay team. Three games in 3 days. Just don't want to let it get scrappy and let Brisbane hang around. As Zach Carter throws up a trademark air ball from the corner. But Jake Davis, is playing fantastic game today for a young kid. 2 points a game on the season. He is doing a fantastic job out there at the moment.
Ed Davis, though, gets called for the reach-in on the defensive end. So they are in the penalty. So Mackay's going to shoot some free throws from here on out. But Jake Davis was hurt last year. He was a big part. I remember speaking to Coach Tarrant before the 2015 season, and he had big raps on Jake Davis. Unfortunately, Davis hurt himself and was out for the season. But he's showing, you know, why Coach Tarrant had such high hopes for him. Bruce at the line for two shots. 53 seconds to go in the half. Bruce hits the second as well.
See Mackay going to a zone here to close the half out.
Davis is going to fire from three. That's strong. Bruce with the rebound, hits Gamblin. They get it over to Cedar now. Bruce going to fire a three. He's fouled by Alex Barker. That's just a bad foul there. He had pretty good position, but he left his feet.
Well, Bruce again, just knowing the clock. And that's what you want your point guard to do. 33 seconds left. Let's get a two-fun. We'll get a shot up here, and then it's our ball to close the quarter out. So he takes what is a pretty quick three, and I mean, much to Mackay's liking, there's a silly foul committed and with a chance to really push the lead out here. And then Mackay gets the last possession again, so big 30 seconds coming up to close the half.
Yeah, and Barker is a key contributor off the bench for Brisbane. He hasn't put up the biggest stats, but he can guard 1 through 5, and he's quite often asked to guard 1 through 5 as well. And that was his fourth personal, so I don't think we'll see Alex Barker for a little while for Brisbane. Bruce is just stroking it from the free throw line. He's just absolutely crushing it tonight. Let's have a look at Sean Bruce. 18.7 rebounds, 2 assists. Hits all three as well. And I thought Bruce might get a bit of a breather to end the half here, but Rasmussen checks in for Mitch Gamblin.
Well, I reckon Bruce will get a breather at the half. They want him to have the ball for the last possession here because he's just got it on a string at the moment and obviously feeling pretty good.
Jeffries has it for Brisbane. He'll fire a deep three that rolls in and out. Great offensive rebound by Thompson. There's a scrap for it under the basket. It's knocked out of bounds. They're going to say it went off of Rasmussen. It's about 17 seconds to go. So Brisbane will actually have it for the final shot.
If they hold it that long, we will see.
It's true.
A quick three could be on the cards.
Anderson checking back in for Brisbane.
Tom Malloy is going to come back into the game in the second half. Looking pretty mean by the look of this tape job he's got going on.
Yeah, he looks like a rugby league player with the all blood band. Not really sure what the holdup is here. Referees are at the scoring bench. So 17 seconds on the game clock, 14 on the shot clock. Thompson takes the inbounds pass. Now Anderson has it. Over to Carter. Into the corner for Davis. Now Anderson. Anderson uses the pump fake. Skips the pass inside, but it's thrown out of bounds. And Thompson wasn't ready for it.
And Mackay and Sean Bruce have got a full 7 seconds, which is an enormous amount of time to get a quality look.
Bruce going left, throws up the alley-oop. Harvey, though, it hits the front of the rim. That's no good. Bruce, it was a good look, but it was just threw it just a bit short. And heading into the halftime break, it's a 14-point lead for Mackay, 59-45. Thunder, I think both teams can take some positives, but there's certainly a bit to work on for both sides as well.
I agree. I think Mackay is feeling pretty good about themselves, the position they're in. Obviously, coming down three games in 3 days, like we've spoken about a few times, and looking poised in full control of the game, really, playing the style that they want to play, to go home with a clean sweep of the trip, which is an awesome result for any team, but especially a team like them trying to get their title defense back on track. And I think Brisbane, we've spoken about it a few times, and I don't want to be overly critical, but they must make adjustments to the style that they're playing, because what they're doing at the moment just isn't working. And I know Dusty Reichardt's got 2 fouls, and he missed a preseason with a trip back home to the States. But when even someone like that, they just need to do, I think, a better job down 14 to come back out and work harder to get some really quality looks for some specific guys. Let's get Dusty the ball on the block a few times. Let him play out of that. Because at the moment, the 1-2 pass, jack up a three, if they're shooting well, is great, and it looks really good. But at the moment, they're not shooting well, so they've got to make an adjustment, and they're just failing to do that at the moment.
Yeah, and I think one thing I'd like to see out of Brisbane also, keep Aaron Anderson on the floor.
I agree. Well, why don't we run some two-man action, with Anderson and Dusty Reichardt, and just look something different, see how Mackay guarded. And I mean, they've got a number of great shooters, Jeffries and Drew Phillips and Jake Davis even today. Put them on the weak side and just see what they can get out of it. But at the moment, when you do the same thing over and over and over, teams get used to guarding it and they get pretty comfortable defensively. And I think, at least looking from up here, that's how Mackay's feeling at the moment.
Yeah, well, it's halftime, so we're going to take a break. We'll come back with some halftime statistics just before the start of the second half. It's 59-45, Mackay over Brisbane here in the QBL Game of the Week presented to you by Nothing But Net Media.
In-depth video analysis is no longer just for the pros. Huddle is an easy and affordable tool that brings professional-level insight to club and high school teams. Just film and track events live at games and upload them to huddle.com. Accelerate player development with team messaging, automatically generated shot charts and reports, and the ability to add notes and drawings to your video. Coaches can exchange game footage with their entire league, all from one place. Huddle even allows athletes to create highlights to help them get noticed. Sign up for a free trial to see for yourself how Huddle helps teams win. In-depth video analysis is no longer just for the pros. Huddle is an easy and affordable tool that brings professional-level insight to club and high school teams. Just film and track events live at games and upload them to huddle.com. Accelerate player development with team messaging, automatically generated shot charts and reports, and the ability to add notes and drawings to your video. Coaches can exchange game footage with their entire league, all from one place. Sign up for a free trial to see for yourself how Huddle helps teams win.
Welcome back to NAB Stadium here in Auchenflower as the Mackay Meteors lead the Brisbane Capitals 59-45 at the half. Dan, it was a pretty good first half, a bit sloppy at times, but Mackay certainly put their stamp on it. Let's take a quick look at their stats in the first half.
Well, it's a pretty even spread. Looking at Brisbane, no one's really stood out too much, I don't think, in terms of contributions. But coming back to a couple of comments we made earlier, John, Brisbane's down, 14 or so at halftime. So they've got their work cut out for them. So how are they going to claw it back? Who knows what was discussed at halftime. But we've got Anderson with 6 shots in the first half, and Dusty Reichardt's 1 of 5. So 5 attempts for him in 11 minutes. So hopefully we see both of those guys get involved heavily here and get themselves opportunities to get on the score sheet and drive their team back into some positive territory and claw this game back. Whereas at the other end, Sean Bruce, we spoke about him coming back to the NBL and what he's going to bring. But we're looking at him at 21 points and 8 rebounds at the half for a guard, just controlling the game so well. And I mean, Mackay's got 7 turnovers only, which is pretty good on the third game of a triple header. Shows that they're playing in control and to a pace that's to their liking, I think. So I think if I'm Mackay, we just want more of the same, whereas Brisbane's got to change up how we guard Mackay. We've got to change up the offense we're playing and really focus in on who do we want to get shots. And if I'm Jeff Tarrant, I want Dusty Reichardt taking 12 or 13 shots this half. So let's see if that happens or not.
Yeah, I also expect to see a bit more pressure and defense from Brisbane in the sense of switching things up, going to zone, going to man, picking up half court, picking up full court, a bit of trapping here and there. And I think Mackay, I think they've shown what they can do. They're a very poised team. They're a veteran team. They do have some young guys, but across the board, they're guys who have been in this competition. You have a guy like Sean Bruce and Chris Cedar who have played at the NBL level. You have TJ Diop and Rasmussen who have been around the league for a long time. And you've got a Nick Wiggins who is a super talented guy. So I think the key for Mackay is to really just continue to stay level. Don't want to get too high, don't want to get too low. Just kind of continue to do what they're doing. They definitely have to anticipate a big push from Brisbane. They have to recognize the fact that Brisbane is going to make a run. There's no doubt about it. Yeah. They just have to weather that storm and continue to play the way they play in the first half.
Well, Brisbane have to bring some energy to start the half, so you have to expect that. But Mackay might have 4 or 5 main contributors. And on the surface, you think, geez, they're not very deep. But that means that everyone else on the team knows exactly who's going to take the shots, whereas Brisbane have 12 guys that all want to shoot it. So I think structurally they struggle a little bit. But anyway, we get Dusty with a touch to start the half, and he's fouled. And hopefully he remains the focus for the next few minutes at least.
I know you're happy, Dan. Dusty got the touch early, which was good.
Anytime we get big guys getting looks, I'm happy.
Jeffrey's baseline jumper, no good. Cedar skies for the rebound. And this is the difference that you see here, Mackay. They're very methodical. If it's there, they take it. They don't force much. Reichardt with the long catch and layup is good. It's a good look there from Anderson to Reichardt. And we see already Brisbane kind of extending their defense out and then picking up a little more pressure as Job gets called for the offensive foul. That's his second personal. It's already 2 team fouls for Mackay. And immediately Coach Furdek goes to the bench, inserting Luke Harvey for TJ Diop.
Well, obviously, the coach knows more about the team than we do, but why would you take him out 40 seconds into the third quarter after 1 foul? He's one of your go-to guys, looked really dangerous early. One bad possession and he's out. That surprises me.
Yeah, Jeffries misses another jump shot. Bruce throws the alley-oop for Wiggins. It's not there. He misses the dunk attempt afterwards also. Anderson now with the Jets. Hits Thompson cutting to the basket. Flips it up. No good. Fighting for the rebound. Rasmussen comes down with it. I know you were up in your seats for that alley-oop there, Thunder.
Well, we all want to see dunks, but I don't know how he missed it.
Anderson with the tip and steal. Quick transition bucket. It's a 10-point lead now for Mackay. And I've said this before. I know Coach Tarrant. I'm not questioning what he does, but if I'm Coach Tarrant, I leave Aaron Anderson on the floor at all times.
Yeah, especially in this situation. And offensively, he's going to create and score, but I mean, that's the second or third steal he's got this half alone. Just defensively, he's causing Mackay a lot of issues in this quarter and gets a three ball to rim out as well. But, I mean, he's got to play 20 minutes here. Absolutely.
Oh, tough pass there by Bruce. And it is stolen by Dusty Reichardt. Probably not a smart play there by Sean Bruce. Brisbane getting back into this here. Anderson thinks about a three. Looks inside for Jeffries on the block. Working against Rasmussen. He'll kick it out. Reichardt has it. Working against Harvey. Good defense there. Entry pass for Carter, who lays it in. Give it to Dusty, and good things happen there.
Absolutely.
Here's a bit of a half-court trap. Bruce now hits Cedar. He's going to fire for three. That's good. The three-point shot is the great equalizer.
It sure is. And McCart had a few sloppy possessions. Turned the ball over maybe three or four times in the first six, seven possessions of the half. So to get a bucket like that, regain some composure, it's much needed for them, and just keeps this buffer at about 11 points. But Brisbane, to their credit, are playing a lot better offense here, moving the ball more, getting some looks inside and opening the floor up. So that hopefully will continue for them as Cedar with a heat check.
It was an early heat check there. Wiggins finds Harvey inside. He's blocked by Carter, but they're going to call the foul. Zach Carter's got to be careful here. It looked pretty good. But Harvey's going to go to the line for two shots. What do you think, Thunder?
I think it would have been awesome if Harvey had have dunked all over him. That would have been great. But I give Zach credit. He's not known as being the toughest foreman in the world. So for him to get up and at least contest the ball is credit to him. And unfortunately for Brisbane, he got called for a foul.
So Harvey's going to be at the line for two shots. Hits the first one. Harvey on the season only shoots 40% from the charity stripe. And he misses the second. Let's see if Brisbane can maintain this ball movement here. They don't start settling again. Jeffrey's going to fire a deep three. That's short. Good rebound there by Wiggins. Bruce skips it ahead now for Cedar. Cedar going left, going to bring things back out. Working against three defenders, pushes off. He's blocked by Jeffries. Thompson saves it. Good defense and good help defense there by Jeffries. Carter now looking to kick it out for Jeffries. Crossover steps into a jump shot that rolls in and out. Good old toilet bowl. Bruce a bit out of control, winds up with Jeffries. Carter is going to fire for three from the wing. It's good. Zach Carter for three.
But John, I think you made the point earlier about let's see Brisbane get up and put some pressure on up the floor, and you can see it here, and it's really causing Mackay some issues early on and giving Brisbane the chance to get some easy buckets out of transition, which they need at the moment.
Yeah, Thompson gets called for the foul. That's going to be his second personal. TJ Diop going to check back in for Luke Harvey. And I think what you're seeing, though, is Mackay needs to do a better job against the pressure as well. Bruce is trying to beat the pressure by himself. You don't beat the pressure with the dribble, you beat it with the pass.
Well, he's a one-man press break at the moment, which isn't going to work. But Brisbane, I think, have gone to a zone largely because Dusty Reichardt, as smart as he is, has now got three fouls, having fouled out again last week, I believe. So let's see Diop and Rasmussen and even Wiggins in transition trying to get the ball in the rim. And if they can get Dusty Reichardt pick up a fourth foul here in the third quarter, it's going to go a long way to helping Mackay pull out a W this afternoon.
Yeah, it's a shot clock violation there for Mackay. Reichardt is playing with three personal fouls, so he's got to be careful. Anderson gets the defender in the air, hits Thompson. Now Carter's wide open for three again. That one rolls home for Zach Carter. Back-to-back threes, cuts the lead to six. Coach Ken Furtick has seen enough. He's going to take a timeout. So we'll take one as well. 5:26 to go in the third quarter. It's a six-point lead for Mackay here on the QBL Game of the Week, presented to you by Nothing But Net Media.
In-depth video analysis is no longer just for the pros. Huddle is an easy and affordable tool that brings professional-level insight to club and high school teams. Just film and track events live at games and upload them to huddle.com. Accelerate player development with team messaging, automatically generated shot charts and reports, and the ability to add notes and drawings to your video. Coaches can exchange game footage with their entire league, all from one place. Sign up for a free trial to see for yourself how Huddle helps teams win.
Welcome back to NAB Stadium here in Auchenflower, as Brisbane Capitals have put on a bit of a run here to cut their deficit to 6 points, 63-57 with 5:26 to go in the third quarter here. Coach Ken Furtick of the Mackay Meteors calls the timeout to reset the offense. Bruce having a lot of trouble here. Hits Wiggins, who goes baseline for Rasmussen, dribbles into a triple team and turns it over. Jeffries misses the shot. Anderson fires from three. That's no good. Jopp comes up with it. Again, this junk defense that Brisbane's throwing at Mackay with the pressure is giving them fits as Wiggins hits a three. That's a big bucket there for Mackay. They needed that one, Thunder.
That's a not a great shot. When he shot it, I was thinking, what's he doing? But if you can make it, it becomes a great shot pretty quick.
And then Thompson finishes and is fouled by Nick Wiggins. On again, the give and go. They spread out the Mackay defense in that man-to-man. Thompson just passed it to the wing, cut to the basket, got it back, and got the foul.
If I was Mackay, I would almost just switch everything. Go man and just switch it. Even Rasmussen switching on Aaron Anderson, it doesn't matter because they're not going to punish anyone by going to the post, but I just reckon it takes away Brisbane's ball movement because they don't have a whole heap of structure. They just rely on pass and kick. Down screen on the weak side. If you just switch everything, I reckon that takes away a lot of their movement. And after that, the ball seems to get stuck. So that's what I'd go to if I was coaching Mackay, but there's probably a good reason I'm sitting up here and not coaching as well. So,
You're enjoying retirement, Dan.
I sure am.
How's business going?
How's Metis Wealth Management going?
Yeah.
Business is good, absolutely.
Metis Wealth Management, tell us a little bit about them.
Well, what do we do? People oftentimes don't know how to make good decisions with their money, so all we do is help people make smart decisions with their incomes, with their investments, and get everybody heading in the right direction financially. It's a thoroughly rewarding job, helping 25-year-olds and helping 65-year-olds alike. It's wonderful. So.
Yeah, we'll get the website out there for you in a second, Thunder, as the action continues here. Anderson throws up the teardrop. It's no good. Harvey comes down with it. And Mackay here kind of seems a bit rattled in this third quarter. Their lead has been cut to 5, and here comes a bit of pressure again. A lot of contact as well as Wiggins fires from 3 again and hits again. He did it from the left side. This time it's from the right. Anderson through the contact can finish as well. Tell you, Aaron Anderson, he's like a little bullet there on the court.
He sure is. He's a midget from basketball's point of view, but he can use his body pretty effectively just to take away the shot blocking ability of all the defenders, and you saw it in action there. But 6-point game. I mean, this is unfortunate for Mackay, playing right into what Brisbane would want. You can see Mackay probably getting a bit fatigued. Starting to not play as structured offense, and Nick Wiggins with a couple of big buckets keeping their lead out of 6 points. But I think Brisbane's pretty happy for Mackay to live and die by the three.
Tom Malloy just checked back in, fouls Luke Harvey. So that's going to be the fourth team foul for Brisbane. 3:32 to go in the third. It's been a spirited comeback here from Brisbane, 69-62.
Well, it started on the defensive end too, John. Picking up the floor, full court, bringing a bit more energy. I mean, defense has really triggered their offense here, and another stop in that possession with a chance to cut the lead even more.
Yeah, it's actually 68-62. Apologies for that. Drew Phillips left wide open for three. That's short. Cedar hands off for Bruce. Bruce streaking up court. Going to bring things back. Fire wing three. Rolls in and out. Barker with the rebound for Brisbane.
Well, Sean Bruce was shooting at halftime, even after all his teammates had gone back to the bench, and everything was short for him. Would have shot 5 or 6 threes, and they were all off the front of the rim. So you just got to wonder, having had two and a half, really, given his first half performance, pretty big performances this weekend already, how much he's got left, because he's been carrying a fair bit of the load for them today.
And if we look at Bruce's numbers, currently he's got 21 points, 8 rebounds, and 3 assists. He's shooting 6 of 9 from the field, 2 of 3 from three, so doing a pretty good job. He also sent Jacob Davis, though, to the free throw line for 2 shots, and Davis hits the first. See what he's got on the second. Second is good as well, so the lead is now down to four. Coach Verdeck's going to the bench. Rasmussen and Gamblin checking in for Wiggins and Cedar. So Mackay's got Harvey, Rasmussen, Gamblin, Bruce, and Jopp. Brisbane answers with Kopskis, Barker, Davis, Malloy, and Phillips. Bruce, pass is tipped. Harvey's going to fire a long two. That's no good. Barker with a strong rebound. Barker playing with four personals, so he's got to be careful. Barker picks up his dribble, hits Malloy. He's going to fire a baseline jump shot that's short. Jopp comes up with it. Thinks he's going to bust out, then hits Bruce on the run. Hands off for Jopp, who hammers it down.
What a great possession for our viewers. Sean Bruce crossed over Luke Harvey. He broke his ankles, but the floor, and Jopp finished with a dunk.
crossed over his own teammate.
Luke Harvey had no idea what was going on then.
Davis.
Good finish for Jopp. And if I'm a big fella, run the floor, get a dunk. That just helps me go down the other end and play good D as well. So let's see how Jopp closes this quarter out.
They're going to hit Tommy Malloy with the over the back. That's five team fouls now, so they're going to be shots now for Mackay. Should be, yeah. I got it wrong on the scoreboard here. That was a fifth team foul for there we go. We swapped it up. So Harvey was fouled, so he'll go to the line for two shots. Harvey's had a couple of shots already at the free throw line tonight. He's one of two.
Does Mackay fly home or bus home after this, John? What's your guess?
I'd say fly.
They fly.
Three game road trip. Friday night, Saturday night, Sunday. There's no way you want to be driving after that.
Well, in 2002, when I played for the Caps, which coincidentally was the year that the Caps won it, I remember busing to Mackay, to Rockhampton.
That was before they had airplanes, though, right?
Might have been. And then we flew to Cairns. That was about it. So these players these days.
Here we go.
Getting looked after.
Here we go. Kopskis hits Barker, who dumps it in from Malloy. It's nearly stolen. Knocked around a bit. A lot of contact there. Don't know who they're going to give that one to. It looked like it was Mackay on Mackay action. And Alex Barker is going to get called for the foul. He hit the deck trying to get the ball on the ground.
That could be five fouls, I believe.
Yeah, that's his fifth personal. So Alex Barker is going to be done for the night. To me, it looked like the contact was Bruce on Diop. I think Barker was kind of at the bottom of that there. He was the first one on the floor trying to scrap for the ball. I don't know how he got called for that one.
Well, I think there's three guys on the floor hustling, which is awesome. That's what you want to see, but I think the ref just feels obligated to call something, and I think it almost becomes a bit of a guess, because sitting here, we had almost the same view that the official did, and it's pretty hard to tell who hit who. I saw three guys jump on the ball, and you don't like to see anyone get called for a foul that eliminates them from the game, but I mean, Zach Carter comes back in, so I'm not sure that Alex Barker's a huge loss for the Caps this afternoon, but you never want to see someone foul out in that manner.
Yeah, well, I think they're different guys. Barker gives 110%. He's like the kind of the glue, I guess. Whereas Carter is relied on more for his scoring ability. Oh, Kopska shuffled his feet and got called for the travel. Caps and the bench are starting to get into a bit frustrated with the referees. They need to just kind of play through this bit of malaise. They've done such a good job to get the lead down to eight. Don't want to lose focus.
Well, they've done a great job, and that's just a sloppy turnover from Mackay. I think all the great coaches in the world talk about how do you close quarters, especially on the road. So here we go, with a minute left, up eight. How's Mackay going to close this quarter?
Bruce gets his feet in the paint, throws it inside for Wiggins, out and out to Gamblin. Rasmussen has it inside, great look. Jopp reverse layup is no good, but it's tipped by Gamblin. Matt missed as well. It's a great look there from Rasmussen and Jopp.
Jopp has to finish that.
I thought he was going to go under for the reverse dunk.
Well, it might have been on his mind, but Tom Malloy may not be the most athletic man in the world, but he's a big fella. And that might have just played a part of Jopp's mind. He knew there was a seven-footer standing right behind him.
Bruce lays it in off of a nice lead pass from Rasmussen. A lead back into double figures now for Mackay with 39 seconds to go in the quarter. 74-64. Brisbane got to within five. Mackay weathered the storm, and now they retake the 10-point lead. 5 seconds to go on the shot clock. Phillip has it in the corner. Now Carter, double teamed, out to Davis. He's got to fire away. It's a deep three. It's good. He beats the buzzer. 7 points the lead now, and Mackay's going to hold for one shot. They've got 8 seconds to go, but Bruce going to get called for the offensive foul, throwing the forearm.
You asked me earlier, John, if I'm happily retired. I'm just watching Tom Molloy with a bandage around his head step on his own foot and sprain his ankle, I think. I don't miss moments like that. I feel sorry for him. He's a great person from what I can tell, and plays his role really well, but he's in the wars this afternoon, that is for sure.
He's definitely in the wars, but that's all part of it, isn't it, Dan?
Sure is.
I think people forget basketball is a contact sport as well.
It absolutely is.
Anderson going to fire top of the key. Three is long. Wiggins with the big defensive rebound. And heading into the final quarter, it's a 7-point lead for Mackay, 74-67. We're going to take a break, and we'll come back with all your fourth quarter action here on the QBL Game of the Week, presented to you by Nothing But Net Media.
In-depth video analysis is no longer just for the pros. Huddle is an easy and affordable tool that brings professional-level insight to club and high school teams. Just film and track events live at games and upload them to huddle.com. Accelerate player development with team messaging, automatically generated shot charts and reports, and the ability to add notes and drawings to your video. Huddle even allows athletes to create highlights to help them get noticed. Sign up for a free trial to see for yourself how Huddle helps teams win.
Welcome back here to NAB Stadium in Auchenflower. It's a 7-point lead for the Mackay Meteors, 74-67. Dan, let's take a quick look at some stats for both teams. Put you on the spot there, Dan. Sorry about that.
Yeah, a little bit. That's okay. I'm just scrolling through, but again, I come back to the point earlier. Mackay, Sean Bruce, 23 points. Cedar, 17. Wiggins, 14. Jopp, 5 of 8 for 12. They know exactly who's going to take their shots for them. Whereas Brisbane, they've got 10 players that have all played that all want to get shots up. So, and I think that's great. It's good and bad when you've got depth like that. But hopefully Mackay can just stay with their structure, them to get the win. As Anderson with a tough finish.
How's that for a finish? Right through Mitch Gamblin off the Mackay turnover. It's a 5-point lead. Rasmussen
Mackay
answers
at their end.
He comes right back and answers.
I mean, John, watching Anderson on the break, I mean, the Nothing But Net service. I know we've got listeners all over the world, New York City through to different places in America, all tuning in, able to enjoy Sunday afternoon basketball from Brisbane. It's a pretty awesome service we're putting out there, and glad that everyone's enjoying the call wherever they might be.
And we certainly love doing it too. It's a lot of fun for us, and we're very happy to be able to provide it. I think it's a great thing. Not just saying it because we're doing it, but I think it's a great thing for not only the competition, but the game of basketball. Rasmussen fires a three. That's no good. Davis has it stolen by Cedar, who hits Jopp. Hook shot is good.
It's a tough finish. I mean, Jopp's got some class, and I guess you're not an import that keeps coming back unless you've got a bit of game, but he's got some nice touch.
Anderson loses the ball out of bounds. Nearly took out one of the photographers along the baseline there, but he managed to avoid the contact.
So why isn't Brisbane picking up? Sean Bruce is out of the game. Chris Theda's not the fittest athlete in the world looking at him. Very skilled, obviously very smart, but you'd love to see them pick up. And with Bruce out of the game, try and take advantage of the lack of ball handlers from Mackay. As you can see here, the offense is ugly.
And Drew Phillips comes up with a steal. And this is where you want them to run, get out and run a bit more. And now they kind of settled things right back into the half court. Davis going to fire for three. That's a bit strong. Cedar tips it. Wiggins comes down with it for Mackay. Chris Cedar got a bit of a run with the Townsville Crocodiles this past NBL season. They work it around to Wiggins on the baseline. Kicks it out to Chris Cedar. Fires for three. That's strong. And Anderson comes down with the rebound. Good ball movement by Brisbane. Carter winds up within the corner. Fires for three. Rasmussen corrals the defensive rebound. And I'd like to see Mackay run a bit more half court. Work the clock. It's a 9-point lead. We're in the final quarter. Cedar gets it over now to Wiggins. Wiggins has Anderson on him. Skips it to Gamblin. Gamblin's going to fire for three. That's strong. Job can't get it. Good box out there by Thompson.
I agree with you, John. I'd love to see Mackay running more half court and just make Brisbane play defense for 17, 18 seconds. And I mean, if I'm looking at Hamplin shooting a three, that's probably a shot that Brisbane's pretty happy with. You want to see them work the ball around, run their structures, go to Wiggins in the block, go to Jopp in the block, and just make Brisbane really work hard on this end, knowing that they're probably going to struggle to get quality looks at the other end, which is what's been the case so far this afternoon.
Yeah, timeout on the floor. Might as well keep it here, Dan. It's a 78-69 lead for Mackay. Look at that fourth quarter. It was a big run. Brisbane was able to claw back 7 points, but they just were not able to kind of continue that momentum. The referee, they felt, you could tell by their body language, they felt the referees had a lot to do with that as well. A couple of questionable calls, to put it best.
Yeah, probably one or two. Yeah, but they also had a technical foul on Nick Wiggins, which was questionable. So I'm not sure that they can look in the mirror and really blame the refs too much. I actually thought in the third quarter, Brisbane did a really good job offensively, playing with a bit more control. And I thought defensively, they mixed it up really nicely too and played up the floor a bit more and put on some great pressure. So I think that clawback's not a surprise. And just watching the game, they deserved a lot of credit for the changes they did make. But so far, a few minutes into the fourth quarter, they've gone back to their standard way of playing, I guess, in the more trademark, just run and gun and get the shots up, and so far it's not working.
And Mackay giving Bruce a bit of a rest here, deservedly so, as he's played big minutes tonight. And you expect to see him, and there he is, he's back. You didn't think he was going to be out too long.
Well, Mackay did a great job for the first 2.5 minutes of the quarter, nursing a 10-11 point lead and letting him get some rest. So you'd be pretty comfortable now that he's back out, despite turning it over on his first possession, that he's going to bring some stability back to Mackay's offense, and you'd like to see them play under control and really within their structures. And with a point guard like that, you would expect that to be the case.
Anderson hits Thompson. Long two is strong. Rasmussen comes down with it. One thing that has been hurting Mackay in the second half particularly is turnovers, Dan.
Yeah, absolutely.
Great touch pass from Rasmussen. Wiggins can't finish, though. Reichardt comes down with it. Now Thompson has it. Thompson hands off. Carter looks inside. It's knocked out of bounds off the hands of Brad Rasmussen. It's a good idea from Carter. They all definitely thought he was going to shoot it, and he went inside.
Yeah, definitely a good look.
Jeffries inbounds. Back out to half court to Anderson. Got about 15 on the shot clock. Anderson's going to fire a wing three. He hits it, and he's fouled. That's a three-point basket, and Anderson's fouled by Sean Bruce. So he's going to go to the line for a four-point play. I can never understand why people, if you're going to contest the shot, you contest it, but you're never going to block it coming sideways. You're never going to. Bruce made the cardinal mistake of leaving his feet, coming at him at an angle.
Yeah, I've never understood that either. And we talk about basketball IQ a lot. I mean, Anderson is experienced. The game's now a 5-point game after that 4-point play. But the basketball IQ, when if I'm a pro going to the NBL, I'm not sure what I'm doing fouling a 3-point shooter in that situation. But and Anderson with the quality D at the other end as well.
And Anderson blocked Bruce's 3-point attempt. Now Anderson has it in the corner. His three is good. Aaron Anderson heating up here. He's got 7 straight. The lead is down to 2 for Mackay, 78-76. Brisbane doing it defensively. Cedar looking to break the streak as it's stripped, but they're going to maintain possession. And again, it's turnovers that are really hurting Mackay.
Well, Mackay's now playing Brisbane-style basketball. The first 3.5 quarters of the match, for most of it, they're playing within their system, getting the shots they wanted, whereas Brisbane, obviously, as we've discussed, is a fan of run and gun and no structure, and that's what Mackay's resorted to. So you would hope, with some smarts out there and Cedar, who's experienced, Sean Bruce, who we've discussed at length in his experience, they've just got to have enough composure to take the ball out, hold up the play, run what they want to run, and get the looks they want to get, because at the moment they're playing exactly the style that Brisbane wants them to.
Yeah, and Coach Jeff Tarrant just has been warned, so a bench warning given to the Brisbane Capitals bench. Coach Tarrant not happy about something. Bruce gets it, working around a Carter screen. He nearly loses it. It winds up with Cedar, who fires from three. That hits the back of the rim, no good. Reichardt with the board, hands off to Anderson. Anderson has got seven straight now for Brisbane. Dusty handing it back to his point guard. Now Dusty has it, going to fire a long two. That's no good. Thompson with the offensive rebound. Putback is good, and we're all tied at 78. It's a new game with 5:30 to go in the game. Bruce isolating on Reichardt. He wants everyone to clear out.
You can see Brisbane just switching everything.
Bruce leaves his feet,
unable to take advantage.
Now Wiggins winds up with it. He gets his feet in the paint. A lot of contact. They're going to call Nick Wiggins for the charge. Dusty Reichardt stepping up and taking that one. Coach Furtick not happy about it for Mackay. It was a lot of contact. And to make matters worse, Nick Wiggins down, clutching his calf. He's going to ask his teammates to help him up. He'll limp it off. Looks like he'll be all right. And try and stick through it. I like to see that out of everyone. If you can tough it out, give it a crack.
I think you've got to. Yeah, we've had a couple of gestures from the crowd for Mackay to call a timeout, and I was thinking the same thing. You've got two timeouts left, 5 minutes to go. You want to save them, because in the last minute or two, you want as many as you can get. But given the run that Brisbane's on and the style of basketball that you're playing at the moment, if I was the Mackay coach, I would absolutely be calling a timeout and just trying to get some composure back in my squad.
A good D here. Carter winds up with a baseline floater, no good. Now Bruce has it. Let's see what Sean Bruce has. He's looking for the horn set. There's only one horn. He didn't use it. Bruce double teamed, a lot of contact. And he's going to get called for the foul. Let's see who they give that one to. Going to give it to Kurt Thompson. That's Thompson's third personal. It's the second team foul on Brisbane.
Well, we just saw Sean Bruce dribble the ball for 13 seconds of the shot clock, which is not what has been happening so far this afternoon, and I agree that Mackay's coach, burn a timeout. You only have one left, but you need to get some composure back in your team here, or else Brisbane's going to run over the top of you.
Bruce cannot hit the three. Ball's knocked out of bounds, though, by Aaron Anderson. So Mackay will get the fresh 14-second shot clock, and we haven't seen that ball movement for Mackay either. A lot of dribbling, bunch of dribbles and then shooting as Bruce comes off the screen, fires the baseline jump shot. That's no good either. Another tight one here for Mackay. They won by 1 point last night. Jeffries puts it on the deck, picks up his dribble, looking for Anderson. There's 8 seconds to go on the shot clock. Anderson gets a screen from Reichardt, kicks it back out to Dusty, fires a long two. That's good. Well, and the Capitals take the lead for the first time in ages.
Well, they've given him three for that, John. But it became an Anderson-Reichardt pick and roll. Simple two-man game, and Dusty gets a wide-open shot. I don't know why they don't run that two out of every four possessions. It just doesn't make sense to me. But they did there and got a quality look.
Bruce hits Wiggins. Wiggins puts it on the deck. Step back three is well short, but the ball is knocked out of bounds. It looked like it went off of Dusty Reichardt.
It sure did.
Sure looked like it went off a Reichardt, but they're going to give it to Brisbane.
Well, Dusty does what every veteran does and just walk it off as if it was the right call.
And here's the timeout that we were looking for from Coach Ken Furtick. 3:39 to go. Mackay now trails by three. We're going to take a timeout as well. We'll bring back the exciting conclusion to this game between the Mackay Meteors and the Brisbane Capitals here on Nothing But Net Media.
In-depth video analysis is no longer just for the pros. Huddle is an easy and affordable tool that brings professional-level insight to club and high school teams. Just film and track events live at games and upload them to huddle.com. Accelerate player development with team messaging, automatically generated shot charts and reports, and the ability to add notes and drawings to your video. Coaches can exchange game footage with their entire league, all from one place. Huddle even allows athletes to create highlights to help them get noticed. Sign up for a free trial to see for yourself how Huddle helps teams win.
Welcome back to NAB Stadium here in Auchenflower. It's now an 81-78 lead. Brisbane outscoring Mackay here in the fourth quarter, 14-4, to recapture a lead that they haven't had at all. I think this is their first lead of the game.
There might have been a 1 or 2 point lead in the first quarter, maybe on the first couple of buckets, but I mean that must have been a 10 or 11 point run for Brisbane. So Mackay left their timeout pretty late, but here we go, 3 point game with 3:30 left.
Yeah, they're going to double and they're going to show. Kopskis is left wide open though on the corner. Three, no good. Reichardt with the offensive rebound. Gets it out to Jeffries, who hands off for Anderson. With eight seconds to go on the shot clock. Jeffries is going to fire a deep three that's a bit too strong. Harvey comes down with it for Mackay. Gets it over to Cedar now. Cedar up ahead to Wiggins. Inside for Bruce. He's fouled and fouled hard by Ryan Jeffries.
That's a good foul. Nothing wrong with that. Can we explain why Jopp is on the bench with 3 minutes left? I thought he was playing really good, got a nice touch, defends pretty well. But he's sitting down at the moment.
I'm not really sure unless they just want to get him a bit of a breather. They're going to go to Harvey here instead of TJ Jopp. Bruce hits the first one. It's going to be another nail biter between these two clubs. Second one good as well. 81-80. Brisbane now the lead cut to one. Carter, corner three is a bit short. Bruce comes down with it. He's going to run up court. Skips it over to Wiggins. Wiggins going baseline, picks up his dribble. Now Rasmussen has it over to Bruce in the corner. Cedar wide open, top of the key, is going to fire a three. That's strong. Fighting for the rebound. Ball goes out of bounds off of Anthony Kopskis. So Mackay will have a 14-second shot clock and a baseline out of bounds just to the side of the Brisbane basket.
Sean Bruce has got some great baseline jump shot looks out of this play. And there's another one. How do you not guard that? He's done it about five times today.
82-81 as Dan plays the predictor. He can see into the future. 2:25 now to go in the game. 1 point lead for Brisbane. Excuse me, Mackay. Brisbane and Mackay going back and forth. Reichardt jumper is good. So it is a 1 point lead for Brisbane now. Crowd really getting into this one this afternoon. These teams have developed quite the rivalry as Harvey steps and fires a long two, which is good. Harvey doesn't look pretty, but he can hit those ones. I've seen him hit plenty of them over the years.
Well, I take it back. Jopp on the bench has been a great move because that was...
As Anderson hits an absolute wild one, and he's fouled. The man is magic. He's got the ball on a string. I thought the foul was a dubious foul call because he kind of kicked his leg out, but the referees gave it to him. He was able to hit the shot and get the foul. That's the second time we've seen Anderson do it. And gee, I told you, we mentioned Aaron Anderson. I want to give myself a lot of credit, but I told you, you don't want him leaving the floor. He hasn't left it in the second half, and Brisbane's now taking the lead.
I don't know what he's got numbers-wise. Offensively, he's been great, but defensively, I think, is where he's had his main impact. He's been fantastic for Brisbane. It just really brought energy, which is what they desperately needed.
Bruce, foul line jump shot, no good. Jopp gets his hand on it, but Reichardt comes down with it. We now got about a minute 30 to go in the game, and it's a two-point lead here for Brisbane, 86-84. Kopskis open for three. He fires, and that rolls out. Tip to Cedar. Cedar gets the ball, kicks it ahead for Wiggins. Wiggins going right at the defense. He's fouled. That's a good foul there by Kopskis. He definitely went for the ball, sending Nick Wiggins to the line for two. Let's see. Nick Wiggins on the night. He's only been to the free throw line two times, so this is going to be his third and fourth free throws. But on the season, he shoots only 67%.
Yeah. Two big ones coming up.
First one is short from Wiggins.
That is a sign. When it's that short, that's a sign of feeling the pressure.
What about fatigue?
Well, I think his 2K clutch rating just went down.
Second one is no good either. Thompson comes down with it. Three games in 3 days, Thunder. That doesn't help either.
Certainly doesn't.
So Brisbane can hold till it's under a minute here. They've got the two-point lead. Anderson gets the screen from Reichardt, splits the D, flips one up. It's short. Cedar comes up with it now. Mackay looking to run.
Cedar spins around
and loses the ball. Jeffries comes up with it. Mackay's going to have to start trapping or something here as Anderson's going to fire a wing three. It rolls in and out. Jeffries nearly saves it. The ball goes out of bounds off of Brisbane, and Mackay will have possession with just about 50 seconds to go here.
Jeez, Mackay, well, lucky there, John, leaving a wide open Anderson three after a pretty sloppy turnover. Let's see what they go to here. They must work hard and just get a good look down two. They'll have two possessions to close the gamut if they do it properly, so let's see what they go to.
Bruce now has it working on Kopskis. Reichardt shows. Cedar skips it over to Rasmussen, fires a wing three. It's short. Anderson comes down with the rebound with 30 seconds to go. You don't need to foul here, but you don't want to give them a good look.
I don't know Mackay that well, but I'm pretty sure that a Rasmussen three when you're down two is not the play that they were looking for. But he was open and he took it, and unfortunately for them, he missed it.
Anderson, though, turns it over. He was looking for the contact call on Chris Cedar. Good defense there by Cedar. 15.5 to go in the game. There's a timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. It's a two-point lead for Brisbane heading into the stretch here. You're watching QBL TV, presented to you by Nothing But Net Media.
In-depth video analysis is no longer just for the pros. Huddle is an easy and affordable tool that brings professional-level insight to club and high school teams. Just film and track events live at games and upload them to huddle.com. Accelerate player development with team messaging, automatically generated shot charts and reports, and the ability to add notes and drawings to your video. Coaches can exchange game footage with their entire league, all from one place. Huddle even allows athletes to create highlights to help them get noticed. Sign up for a free trial to see for yourself how Huddle helps teams win.
Welcome back to NAB Stadium here. 15 seconds to go. Mackay down two, 86-84. Dan, we were just talking in that break. What do you do here if you're Mackay? Do you try and get a quick two and foul, or do you hold for the final shot and go all or nothing?
For me, I want to shoot it with about 5 seconds left to give my rebounders a chance to get a tip, but not enough time for Brisbane to go length of the floor for another bucket. So if it was me, I'd come out of this with a Diop, Sean Bruce side on ball, let Bruce create for himself, mid-range J, or if they trap that, kick it to a Cedar on the wing for a three. That's what I would do.
All right, well, let's see. Cedar is going to inbound it. They've got Cedar, Rasmussen, Wiggins, Diop, and Bruce. Chris Cedar getting set to inbound. He finds Wiggins open in the corner, drives baseline. He hands off for Diop, who recovers. Cedar's going to fire a three. It's good. Chris Cedar drains the three, and Mick Tarrant has to call the timeout.
John, I think that is pretty much exactly what we just said they would run. A Wiggins almost turnover to Dop, stumbling, falling over, slapping it somehow back to Cedar off balance for the three. I think that's what we said they should run out of the timeout, and it's come off.
Pretty much, but Chris Cedar does it again, hitting the big three. My goodness, Chris Cedar has done it for Mackay here, but there is plenty of time left on the clock. There's only 10 seconds to go. I would have liked to see them work a little bit more clock. It was a great play because Wiggins drove baseline and dumped it down low for an open Diop. The pass was just a bit too low.
Well, I would almost let 5 seconds run off the clock here. Brisbane's going to take the last shot, I think. So I would almost foul with the clock's at 10.1. I'd almost let it run down to 6 or 5 and then take a foul. They've got three team fouls. They've got one to give. And then give Brisbane 5 seconds to try and get a shot up, because 10 seconds is a long time.
Yeah, I think you're 100% right, Dan. I mean, both teams with three team fouls, so they both each have a foul to give. If I'm Mackay, though, I'm packing in the paint here. I'm going to let Brisbane shoot a three. They're not shooting the ball at a great clip tonight from beyond the arc. If I'm Brisbane, though, I'm looking to get the hands in Anderson. Dusty Reichardt pick and roll. If Anderson gets a clear lane to the basket, give it to him. If not, find Dusty cutting or stepping back.
Well, Brisbane have to get the ball to Anderson. You're right. Mackay surely will full deny him out of this side out of bounds. If Anderson touches the ball, they're in a bit of trouble. So Sean Bruce has to make it hard for him to get the catch. And if he does catch it, they have to trap him and get the ball out of his hands because he's been killing them so far in this fourth quarter.
No right guard here for Brisbane. Kopskis getting set to inbound. He hits Jake Davis, who hands off for Anderson. There's seven. He crosses over, and Bruce fouls Aaron Anderson. He's got one to give. So he's going to take it. So you're right, Dan. Just under 6 seconds to go now.
And they got the right look. Jake Davis had to catch it and handing it off, which burns a couple of seconds. So again, with 5.9 left, they do the same thing. Full deny Anderson and see what they can do out of that. But they got to go and trap him.
They're looking to trap. A lot of contact.
Oh, that's lazy.
And they got to call that one. It was pretty good defense, but there was definitely contact. That's going to send Aaron Anderson to the free throw line for two shots. He doesn't want any love. He just wants to focus on the free throws. These free throws can tie and give Brisbane the lead. Anderson shoots at about an 85% clip going into this game. Tonight from the free throw line, Aaron Anderson is a perfect 2 of 2 so far.
He saw that contact well too, didn't he?
It was clear contact.
It sure was, and he left no doubt in the ref's mind that there was contact to be called.
Anderson's first one ties the game at 87. Here comes the big one.
Mackay with no timeouts, so they've got to go the length of the floor in 2.9 here.
Anderson's second one, that's good as well. Let's see what Mackay can do. The inbounds from Wiggins gets inside to Bruce. Bruce dribbles around the defense. He stepped out of bounds. He turns it over. There's a second to go. 1.3 seconds, and it looks like, to me, the Brisbane Capitals are going to get away with the win here, Dan.
It certainly looks that way.
Inbound to Anderson. He throws it up in the air. The clock expires, and the Brisbane Capitals, with a tremendous comeback, to win this game 88-87. It wasn't always pretty, Dan, for the Capitals, but somehow, some way, they managed to pull out the victory.
I think you've just summarized it perfectly. Somehow they got a win because probably wasn't their most polished game. I thought Mackay controlled it for 3.5 quarters. They let the tempo go a little bit towards Brisbane's way in the fourth for 5 or 6 minutes, and the energy that Anderson brought offensively and defensively, I thought, changed the whole dynamic of the game. And unfortunately, Mackay lost their structure and lost the composure a bit, and the lead withered away, and you can just see the frustration. Sean Bruce can't believe it.
Yeah, a lot of turnovers there in the second half for Mackay. Brisbane really amped up the defensive levels, forcing Mackay into a lot of bad possessions and a lot of sloppy passes, and they took advantage of it. It took them the entire 40 minutes to get there, but Brisbane managed to pull out the 88-87 win. Take a quick look at the final stats. Aaron Anderson did it all for Brisbane. 26 points, 8 rebounds, 4 assists. He was 9 of 18 from the field, 4 of 10 from 3. Also in double figures for Brisbane, Zach Carter with 13 and Ryan Jeffries with 12. Also, Jake Davis had a great game with 13. Brisbane shot only 37% from the field, 43% from 2, 30% from 3. But they were able to get the ball inside. They scored 26 points in the paint and 25 points off of turnovers. You look at Mackay, leading the way for Mackay was Sean Bruce, 27 points, 9 rebounds, 4 assists. Chris Cedar had 20 points, 7 rebounds. Nick Wiggins with 14 points, 8 rebounds, and 7 assists. TJ Diop with 14. But that's pretty much all the scoring there for Mackay. They shot 43% from the field, 32% from 3, 70% from the free throw line, but they turned the ball over 23 times. And I think, to me, that's what lost the game for Mackay, those turnovers.
Well, they had 7 at halftime. So there's 16 second-half turnovers, which absolutely kills them, no doubt about it. That's hard to come back from. And, I mean, Jock played 27 minutes, not too bad, but 8 shots. I said a few times in the call, John, I would have loved to see him become more of a focus for them. Brisbane had Dusty Reichardt in foul trouble. Tom Malloy had a bandaged head and a sprained ankle for half the game. I would have loved to see them go inside and just grind it out a little bit more, but instead, the pace of the game in the second half and the fourth quarter especially suited Brisbane. they got to play at their tempo, and in the end it played into their hands and they got a good win in front of their home crowd.
Well, that's going to wrap things up for us here in Auchenflower. It's an 88-87 win for the Brisbane Capitals over the Mackay Meteors. I got to take this time to thank Chris Sieber again on the camera. Also want to thank you, Dan, for doing a great job for me. Also thank Braden Hesselhurst for sitting in the booth with us in the women's game. And thank everyone for tuning in. We'll bring another game for you next weekend here on QBL TV, presented to you by Nothing But Net Media.